Okay, class, let's look at the skin. Now, this part is your scalp. This part is your armpit. And this part is actually the bottom of your foot. How do I know it's the bottom of your foot? Well, if you look at the epidermis here, remember your soles of your foot and your hand has an extra layer called the stratum lucidum, and that's this yellow looking layer right there. So remember the layers, okay? Here's the epidermis, here's the dermis, and here is the hypodermis. Now, this layer, about 20 or 25 cells, are all dead keratinocytes. Okay, that's the stratum corneum. This is the stratum lucidum, only found in the soles of the feet. As you can see, the stratum lucidum isn't found in your armpit, is not found in your scalp. Okay, so then you have, what do you have here? Stratum corneum, stratum lucidum. Then if we zoom in on this, we're gonna get something called the stratum what? Can you guess? Is it spinosum? Is it granulosum? You know that stratum basale is down here. Okay, stratum basale is here. If you really zoom in on these, you can see the little granules and the spinosum. If you see them, I don't know if I'm zoomed in a little too much, right? So you see the little granules right here? So you have stratum granulosum, and then you have the stratum spinosum, and then you have the stratum basale, or basale. So again, this is the stratum corneum, stratum lucidum, stratum granulosum, you can see the granules, stratum spinosum, and stratum basale. Now, down here in the dermis, we actually have two layers, right? So we have the papillary layer, and then you have the reticular layer. Remember that your fingerprints and tattoos are in the dermis because you can't wash off your fingerprints and you can't wash off your tattoos. So, and your fingerprints are very distinct. These are Meissner's corpuscles, okay? They detect fine touch. You have the Pacinian corpuscle that detects deep touch, pressure, and vibration. I remember as Al Pacino from Scarface, you know, he causes deep pressure and vibration every time you see him. I know it's cheesy, but at least you'll remember it that way. These are your sweat glands, okay? And you have two different kinds of sweat glands. You have the eccrine, and then you have the apocrine sweat glands. These are your sebaceous oil glands that are found next to the hair. Here's the root, shaft, and bulb. This is the erector pili muscle, okay? So if you look at the soles of the feet, you look at your armpit, and you look at your scalp, pretty much all the layers are the same except for the stratum lucidum that's found right in here. Now these, which are your eccrine glands, they release your normal sweat, which is watery, a little salty. The apocrine glands, these are interesting sweat glands in that they don't really get activated or enlarge until puberty. So you find these in your armpit, your groin, breast for women, in the perineum. Okay, so, and then this is actually releases a certain odor, your pheromones, that can attract you to the opposite sex. They're very common in mammals, not just humans. Okay, and these are the sebaceous glands. Again, so here's the epidermis, dermis, hypodermis. These are your eccrine, apocrine, sebaceous glands, erector pili muscles, Meissner's, Pacinian. Okay, good luck.